SEO for Beginners tutorial, writing search-friendly descriptions. Now, in the previous video, I showed you how to write titles for SEO, which is search engine optimization. So now that you have a search-friendly title for your video, let's write a search-friendly description to get your video in front of an audience. Now, before I get into the technical details, I want to get you in step one right away. Put your title in the description. The most important keywords should be in your title. So your title should also be in your description. The most important keywords should be in the title of your video. So to work towards something that I call keyword alignment, they should also be in your description. The easiest way to do that is just copy and paste the title into the description. You can change it up a little if you want, so that maybe it reads more like a full sentence in case your title doesn't already read like a full sentence, but a copy and paste is just fine. Having your title also in the description will absolutely help your video rank higher in search. If you weren't doing that before, go back and edit your old underperforming videos and do it now. I would recommend specifically target any video getting less than 100 views per month. Any video getting more than that has a certain degree of momentum behind it, and we don't want to disrupt that momentum. Editing the description can sometimes cause that momentum to drop off. So maybe wait until your views on older videos have dropped below 100 per month per video, and then go back in and monkey with the description and title and thumbnail and tags and things. Okay, so that was the big thing. Now on to the technical background about YouTube video descriptions. The description field on a YouTube video has a maximum of 5,000 characters. The more you fill out that description, the better the chance your video will be appearing higher in search and in recommended. But only the first three lines of what you write will appear to someone while they're watching the video. After that, they need to click Show More to see the rest of the description. And even less of your description will appear in search results. It's about the first 120 characters or so, depending on the device that the person is searching on. These two technical facts mean that what appears at the beginning of the description is very important for the viewer or the potential viewer. So you want to put your best stuff right at the beginning of your description, especially in those first 120 characters. You really need to sell people on why they should click on your video. What is it about? And most importantly, what's in it for them? Some people look at video descriptions as if they were blogs, and those people often do very well, because writing a lengthy description, you provide a lot of keywords for the algorithm and search engines to chew on. The more you write that is in line with the subject of your video, the higher the confidence that the search engine has that it knows what your video is about. When it's confident that it knows what your video is about, it shows it to more people that search for that thing. When it's not confident, because there isn't a lot of data points that align with the same terms, it buries your video in search results, because it doesn't want to get it wrong, and it doesn't want to upset the potential viewer, and neither should we. So make sure your description is accurate. If your description does not describe the video, you may get in trouble with YouTube for misrepresenting your content. So if your video is about Las Vegas, don't say it's about unboxing a Dell computer. Now, this doesn't mean that your description should just be a long list of keywords. Quite the opposite, in fact. Your description needs to be complete sentences that make sense. Otherwise, you could get in trouble for something called keyword stuffing. This also doesn't mean that you should just use the same keyword repeatedly in your description. You want to repeat keywords across different fields, like your title and description and tags, but there's no value in repeating it within the same field. Try to use synonyms, other words that mean the same thing. There's an old joke in the search engine optimization world. An SEO expert walks into a bar, pub, tavern, watering hole, saloon, lounge, alehouse, speakeasy. I think you get it. In our last video, we came up with the video title Ray and John's Las Vegas Vacation. Let's say that video focused on going to one specific bar in Las Vegas. The description could say something like, on Ray and John's Las Vegas vacation, they go to their favorite bar. Of all the pubs on the Las Vegas Strip, this is their favorite watering hole. part tavern and part lounge, this is the best ale house around that could easily compete with the finest saloons from the Old West or speakeasies from the days of Prohibition. Now, if someone were to search all of those different words that all mean bar, there's a chance that video would come up as a result. One person thinks bar, another person thinks pub, someone else thinks tavern, but they all basically want the same thing, and they could all potentially benefit from this video. And I managed to get all those keywords in there organically in full sentences. It provides value to both the viewer who chooses to read it and the machine learning search engine algorithm and spiders and things who are desperate for data to process. You may have noticed that blue words appear above the title of a video with a hashtag, or also known as a pound symbol. To add these to the video, put them anywhere in the description and they will appear above the title. Since it doesn't matter where in the description they are, I recommend putting them at the very end, and only three will appear above the title, so limit yourself to just three. You can, of course, add other things to your description as well, such as links to merchandise or other videos, but that doesn't really impact SEO, so we'll save that for another video. Stay tuned for an upcoming video all about tags and how to optimize and maximize those for SEO. Question of the day. How long are your descriptions? What do you put in them? Let us know in the comments below. On average, how long are they and what kind of stuff do you include? If you found this video useful, please give it a like to help other people discover it. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel for more videos about how to succeed on YouTube. Turn on notifications and you can join us during our next live stream and maybe get a free channel review. Thanks for watching and check out the other videos on the channel and see how you can boost your channel to the next level. Thanks for watching.